We are at a point in this country right now where not only is the capitalist system in a crisis of legitimacy and of stability, but that those crises then have created a serious process of immiseration.
Where there's just this profit-driven economy, it's not good for the vast majority of people, for the planet.
COVID-19 has dramatically and vividly exposed the contradictions of capitalism.
The disparity between how the rich have grown their wealth during the pandemic, yet the workers are struggling to make ends meet.
There's people who are facing food insecurity, which we all know is a euphemism for hunger. There are all these people who have lost their jobs. People who stop looking for work because there's no work.
We realize that both parties work together to betray the interest of working class people.
Last November, after the election, we knew that this was only a change of management. Biden was going to continue ICE. He was going to continue concentration camps.
We won't achieve liberation via the Democratic or Republican parties. We need our own party. Of, by, and for the working class.
It's vitally important that we have a genuine socialist alternative to the two capitalist ruling class parties.
So it's clearer than ever that an independent revolutionary movement has to be built, developed, strengthened, and further organized.
The PSL is made up of poor and working class and oppressed people all over this country who are fed up with this system.
We are a party of leaders, of activists, of organizers in all parts of the United States, all around the country, in different sectors, whether it's the environment, whether it's union organizing, whether it's education, healthcare.
The Party for Socialism and Liberation is committed to supporting anti-imperialist movements.
The PSL has been out there and has really presented itself and positioned itself as the leading organization for working class people. That is why there are so many people that are eager to join the PSL.
And what the PSL is doing is taking these people who are ready to fight and shaping them into organizers, giving them the skills and the training to become really effective leaders in the struggle.
I started out too afraid to speak to a crowd. And now I'm like leading protests with like hundreds of people, and it feels like great and natural, and I feel so like protected by the party and lifted up.
We have been here working and fighting for the people because the capitalist ruling class certainly won't.
During the pandemic, many people were forced to stay home, of course, to maintain security, maintain safety. And one would think that the party maybe would become quiet.
When the pandemic hit, you know, it was very confusing. It was a question of how do we continue to organize during this, because stopping was out of the question.
Changing the ways in which we organize and engage with the masses, the PSL has been able to engage in mass struggles that have arisen due to the material conditions caused by the pandemic.
At the beginning of the pandemic, car caravans, you know, they were a new thing. We only had about 20 to 30 cars. But now, because of the work of the party, we are able to organize effective car caravans with over 200 cars.
We immediately intervened in this health and economic crisis. From the struggle to reopen schools, we intervened with our unions.
The Amazon union drive in Alabama, in Atlanta, standing up against anti-Asian racism.
Just here in Albuquerque, we had our File Together, Fight Together program, where we signed working class people up for stimulus checks.
Here in the Denver area, the PSL has been deeply involved in the struggle for justice for Elijah McClain, who was a young black man who was brutally tortured and murdered by the Aurora Police Department in August of 2019.
We have still taking a leadership role in the rebellion against racism that took place this summer in some cities. I mean, being able to lead, you know, massive demonstrations.
We also immediately called for canceling all rents and mortgages and preventing any debt accumulation, because we know that capitalists use these opportunities to escalate the attack on working people.
The PSL also runs candidates like Gloria La Riva because we recognize the working class people are looking for an alternative to the corrupt bourgeois two-party capitalist system.
I mean, it's nothing less than amazing, really, because I think the party, because of its structure and its flexibility and its nimbleness, was able to turn on a dime and completely shift its work so that the party can continue to advance its program and can continue to provide leadership for the movement.
Everywhere that we enter the struggle in our communities, which is now in over 100 cities and towns all over the country, we are coming in and bringing, you know, something that's really valuable, bringing organization, bringing training, bringing clarity, and that is advancing the struggles of communities all over the country.
The Party for Socialism and Liberation is a revolutionary workers' party in the heartland of world imperialism. And contributions like yours allows us to intervene directly in the class struggle.
Supporting the work of the PSL, in my opinion, is just one way of really supporting the progressive movement in general.
And only through supporting the work of the party and fighting against this imperialist empire will we be able to find liberation for all workers.
So please contribute whatever you can to the national fund drive.